morning, Royal Hunts. My name's Mick Robertson. Thanks very much for letting Magpie join you today.
Not at all.
Here at Dunraven Park.
Good.
And we've mapped out a stiff walk for you to show off some of the project work of the North Ely Community Project. So we've got to walk up that hill.
Closely,
I am. I'm going to try, yes. So we've got to walk up that hill to start with.
I see. Good.
I know the appeal's far from closed, sir, but how successful has it been?
Well, I mean, personally, I think it has been a great success. It's raised now over £12 million since it started in April. And I think that's a sign of great success.
Fantastic, fantastic.
I find it very encouraging.
Well, here's the first group of
young people.
It might
raise a little bit more before it's finished.
Oh, I hope so. I'm sure it will. I'd like to introduce you to Tim. Tim Clifford. This is Tim Clifford, who's the chief warden of the area.
Are you from Ely?
No, I'm not. I'm part of the Heritage Coast Project.
Oh, you are?
Yeah.
Ah, very good.
The warden for the area.
So you've got the chain going organised.
Yeah, we're lucky enough to use the
marvellous.
The Ely project as labour for our project. It worked very well, sort of. Jigsaw idea, interlocking. Yeah.
And at the moment you're making some steps, are you? Is that
yes, this was... initially the estate was shut off to the public.
Yes.
It's being turned into a Heritage Coast Park now. And this path was very much used by the public unofficially.
Yes.
And it was very slippy and quite dangerous here.
Yeah.
So we thought what we'd do, as the area's been opened up now as a country park, we'd remake this path here and put some steps in and take out the slippy element.
You haven't got hit by the pickaxe yet. I'm sure you don't put it through your foot.
What led you to create the appeal specifically for young people?
It's a very long story, really, but the whole object of the exercise, you realise, was to try and celebrate the Jubilee.
Yes.
In the sense that the same thing was done for my great-grandfather, King George V, in 35, and there was a great deal of discussion as to whether it should be for old people or you know, you should help restore cathedrals or whatever, or young people. Then it was felt that so much better to try and encourage the young, who represent to a certain extent what happens in the future. And that was really what happened.
Right. I'm surprised that the North Ely community have already managed to get some money from the appeal fund.
Well, this is really part of the whole exercise, to show that we're doing something already.
Yes.
And not just sitting around and wasting our time.
Yes.
And at this point in time, £450,000 has been given out to about 450 projects. And I think that's rather encouraging.
Absolutely marvellous. And in the future, some of the appeal fund is going to be permanently available, isn't it?
That's right.
This is the intention.
Well, the point is, you see, that half the money raised will go back to the local appeals on a county basis, and they've already submitted their projects, which the 450 are from the local appeals. The rest of the money will be kept in a central fund, and the income from that will be used to support projects in all sorts of different areas of the country. And there'll be a system which the leaflets now produced, that people can see what the guidelines are for applying for grants and so on from the central trust.
I was going to ask you about that because I'm sure there'll be lots of young people watching this film, seeing the young people here working and thinking, I could do something like that and I'd really like to get involved. What can they do?
Well, this is always the problem, of course, when you want to start doing something. But if they do it on a school basis, that may be the best way to get together as a group. And write to the Queen Silver Jubilee Trust in London, but the pamphlets and the things will be coming out shortly.
Yes.
And I mean, I won't bother to tell you the address now, but you can tell them later. Perhaps.
Indeed,
that's the best thing.
Indeed, we will. And of course, they do have to have a project that is considered.
I mean, I can't guarantee that every project is going to get support. Obviously.
Right.
One has to pick and choose the best ones. But basically, the idea is to think about projects that help the old or the handicapped or whatever, or environmental ones like this. They're all things that involve working as a team and challenging yourself to a certain extent and doing something useful for everybody else.
Now, this really is superb, isn't it?
Isn't it? Marvellous. The whole southeast wind makes it extremely cold as well.
Indeed.
But it is marvellous, obviously, isn't it, that the public can now come through here and can see this view.
Do you also feel that the energy from young people going into the appeal might be the sort of energy that once went into national service, and maybe we're trying in some ways to replace that aspect?
Yes.
Of
a lot of people say that you ought to have a reintroduction of national service, you know, to be good for people. Well, that's all very well, but you could never have military service introduced again because it's not justified apart from anything else, and it's too difficult to organise. But as far as national community service is concerned, it does occur in other countries, I believe. But again, there are many problems in the way of actually establishing a national voluntary service. My particular hope is that through the Jubilee Appeal activities and so on, the Jubilee Trust and the projects that can establish, that by involving more people and by showing what can be done, perhaps one day somebody may say, well, you know, let's make it a bit more permanent and have it as part of a Princeton school extracurricular activities or something like that.
Mm, indeed.
But it's difficult to establish an actual, you know, national service, I think, now.
Yeah.
Hardy species here.
What are these ones, in fact?
They're Corsican pine, lodgepole pine, and Scots pine. Yeah. And they can bear the salt winds.
Not Sitka spruce, anyway.
No.
A tree I love to hate.
I think everybody does.
I always get into trouble with the forestry commission, I say.
Yeah. We're planting a mixture to try and get a mixture of colours, really.
Yes.
And they grow very quickly, and they'll act as nurse trees for the broadleaved natural British woodland that we'll plant behind.
Uh-huh.
That's the theory of it.
So, and these are quite quick growing, aren't they?
The softwoods are very quick growing, yeah.
And so and 20 years, they're about...
Oh, not quite that. We've got a modifying effect of climate and wind here, which is going to keep them fairly small.
Yes.
But sort of 20 years, they're going to be sort of this high.
Uh-huh.
And they're just going to provide that shelter from the wind to get natural species established behind them, like oak and ash and beech.
Excellent.
And eventually, in many years, we'll reconstitute the woodland, I
hope.
Would you heal one in yourself, sir?
Would you like me to do that?
Very much, please.
You'd probably die instantly.
I'm sure
we'll be removed and planted somewhere else, is usually what happens.
We can...
In here?
In this area would be fine, yes.
Thank you very much. I'll just stick it in and then...
Just stick it in and peel around it.
Do you press it in like that, yeah?
Just cover the roots in.
Leave it like that. And then heal it, didn't you?
Just bang the heel on top of it. That's great.
Is that enough?
Yeah.
Well, it's been fascinating for us to see how some of the money from the appeal is being spent.
Well, I'm delighted.
Little project.
Anyway.
Thanks very much for sparing your time. Where have you got to go now, sir?
Well, I've got to go and give prizes to 180 nurses in Swansea. Very pleasant duty.
Lovely. Well, thank you very much for letting Magpie join you.
Not at all. I was very impressed. Thank you very much.
Bye-bye.